Today our topic is how to analyze qualitative data in research paper.
First of all, we need to understand what is qualitative data and why we use qualitative data in research paper. What is qualitative data? Qualitative data is defined as the data that approximates and characterizes. Qualitative data can be observed and recorded. This data type is non-numerical in nature. This type of data is collected through methods of observations, one-to-one interviews, conducting focus groups, and similar methods. Qualitative data in statistics is also known as categorical data, data that can be arranged categorically based on the attributes and properties of a thing or a phenomenon. Why we use qualitative data in research paper? Qualitative research is used to gain insights into people's feelings and thoughts, which may provide the basis for a future standalone qualitative study or may help researchers to map out survey instruments for use in a quantitative study. Six easy steps are included in qualitative research. Once you have collected all your qualitative data, it's easy to be overwhelmed with the amount of content your methods have created. Qualitative analysis is time-consuming, but benefits from a considered, methodical approach. Step 1. Choose your approach. Hopefully, you chose your analytical plan when you were deciding on your methodology and well before starting data collection. You should have planned how you were going to analyze your data, how that would influence your methods, what data you would collect and how. Here are a few possibilities. First, thematic content analysis. Generating codes that describe themes in the text, such as anxiety or eating habits.
Discourse analysis, looking at the data in the context of a wider discourse, such as political, historical trends or a group setting.
Narrative analysis. Phenomenology. How people describe their own stories, using language, time and metaphor.
Semiotic analysis, hermeneutics, how participants or the researcher understand and interpret the world by their nuanced use of language and words.
Step 2. Develop your framework. There are two main approaches to choose from here. Grounded theory. Emergent coding, inductive data-driven. This is where you don't know beforehand what you are looking for in the data, and identify topics as you are reading it. You are creating theory on the fly. Framework analysis. Structured theory driven, essentially where you use pre-existing theory and your research questions to set out topics you look for before you start the coding process. Step 3. Get to know your data. Qualitative analysis is often an iterative approach, but it really helps to sit down with your data after you have collected it and read it all through before actually starting any analysis. Time constraints can make this feel difficult, but otherwise you may end up having to go back through your data because you noticed an important theme you hadn't coded in the first few sources. Step 4. Choose your technology. This will also depend on the format of your data, especially if it includes multimedia sources like audio, video or pictures. Many people choose to use paper copies of their data, colored highlighters or markers to highlight parts of the data about particular themes. You can also use sticky notes, or cut out sections of data, and stick them onto charts or in files, keeping all your relevant sections together. Step 5. Code and recode. Now you should be ready to go through your data, source by source, line by line, and reduce it into meaningful codes. You should expect this to take some time, for example, as much as 1 to 4 hours for every hour of collected and transcribed interviews. Step 6. Explore and share results. Even before you have finished your coding, you might want to stop and examine the process. What themes are coming up a lot? What connections and trends are being shown in the coding? What is missing? Once you have finished, you will want to share your findings with others. That's a topic in itself, but you can share quotes, images, but mostly write from your experience with analyzing what important factors you have discovered in the data. Thank you for watching. I hope you can easily understand that how to analyze qualitative data in research paper. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.